If you're one of the tens and tens of people that watch my videos regularly, you know I am occasionally visited by the very elegant and beautiful gun fairy. Now, this gun fairy has the power to turn old guns that you may not like so much anymore, you may be tired of, or you just don't know why you bought them. She has the power to turn these old guns into new guns. And the way she does that isn't that magical. I mean, she just turns the old guns into money and then turns the money into something new. Well, I was visited by the gun fairy once again this week, and you might be asking now, well, what old guns did she convert into something new? So I thought I'd take a second here to show you. Now, the first gun she turned into cash was my CZ Rammy BD. Now, this is an awesome little gun, but let's face it, it's a little brick for what it is. If I'm going to carry a smaller gun, it's not going to be this one, so that one had to go. Next was one of my Arsenal Strike 1s. Now, these are great guns, probably one of the best polymer guns ever made, but it's polymer, so it had to go also. Next was a G23 from Glock, and everyone knows these are great guns, but like I said on the other gun, polymer, so it had to go. And finally, a little Beretta Pico. Great little gun, one of the smallest guns I've ever owned that you can actually shoot pretty well, but still, a polymer gun, so poof, it had to go. So now you're asking yourself, well, what did she turn those old guns into? Well, she turned it into this. That's right, it's another Nighthawk. So now let's take a closer look at what's inside the little green bag. Let's get it unzipped here. And you all will see that it is another Nighthawk 1911. Well, when you saw it was Nighthawk, I'm pretty sure you assumed it was a 1911. You may remember I bought another Nighthawk recently, the Trooper, but this one is the Talon. As you can see here on the other side, it says Talon right there. Now, this one has a little more markings on the slide than my other one did, which, you know, I'm not that crazy about, and it has front serrations that I'm not that crazy about. But overall, when you put everything together, even though, like I said, I'm not that crazy about front serrations or a name on the slide, as a package, it works. I really like the way this gun looks. Now, I did not custom order this one. I actually just took one that was in stock at my local dealer because it pretty much had everything I want on it except for an ambi safety, and I would really like to have the barrel here flush cut. But I actually just kind of purchased this one because I thought, well, you know what? I'll do a video on Nighthawk customer service where I send in a gun and get a new safety added and get the barrel crowned, etc., and see how long it takes them and how much it costs. So that's one of the reasons I went ahead and took it the way it was, because I am going to make a few changes to it, like add a magwell, etc. I might add the magwell myself, but we'll see. It's still a little greasy and dirty from being in the case and everything and having my fingerprints all over it, but I think you can see it's a beautiful gun. It's stainless steel with a brushed chrome coating that they then brushed off of the slide. They actually brushed the slide down, or buffed it down, some people might say, after they applied the chrome coating over the stainless. Makes for a really pretty look. And if you ever get tired of the chrome or it starts to wear, you can just bead blast it off and just have a stainless gun. Now, one thing I will have to do to this gun before I send it off even is change the grips. Everyone knows I don't stick to the grips on a gun like this. I have to put my own special touch on it. As for whether I put the magwell on myself and what grips I switch to, I'll do a video on that later. But for now, I just wanted to show you what the Magic Gun Fairy, that beautiful and elegant gun fairy, turned those old guns into this time.